So, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So, today we'll start with the topic of investigational use of drugs. It's a very important topic for a pharmacist, whether he's in a hospital, whether he's in industry, whatever he is, he must know about the investigational drugs. What are these investigational drugs? So, mostly, investigational drugs are used for research drugs. They may be said that sometimes they are going to research, and at the phase four, these drugs has to be applied for on human subjects. These drugs has to be applied on human subjects. For this, you need an investigational use of drugs. So what is the, for research purpose, you can say that it's a pharmaceutical entity that is not permitted for its general distribution and use by the health authorities. So for what you have to drug may be considered for human use, but not approved for human use. So that drug, which is still not fit for human consumption, go for before investigations. So what they do, all the preclinical animals, models, evolution has to be studied. Then safety and efficacy has been established in animals, but not evaluated in human. Then these drugs has to go for investigation use on human. So then they are known as research drugs on experimental. They are known as experimental drugs. They can be, sometimes they may well-known drugs, old drugs with new formulation with respect to excipients, coatings, what they have to investigate. Sometimes the drugs are already in the market. They are on the human beings. They found new ways, new formulation methods. Sometimes they add some new excipients. Sometimes they do new coating solvents. Sometimes they have added new vehicles. They can investigate for stability check, shelf life, cost effectiveness, allergic properties. So for this, they can go for, again, they go for investigational use of drugs. So old drugs and new combination, sometimes they are also be known as investigational drugs. So because still they have to study if safety and efficacy, evolution has to be done for the investigation purpose. They can be transformed to a new dose of forms. So they also need, again, they go for evaluation, and they also applied over the human subjects. Sometimes they also need special labeling, cautions, neutral, limited to investigation use. So these are all matters. They go for investigational use of drugs or cautions. Sometimes they can introduce a new cautions. So they also go for research drugs. Sometimes they need for approval for marketing. So that for this, they also need for investigation drugs. Or further future aspects of drugs, they also go for investigations. Further, they review and approval. So clinical research on human is risky and uncomfortable because when you're going to apply a drug which is unknown, prior to that it was not applied, it was not used, it was not researched on human being. So it's very risky when they are going to apply over the, because when they have applied research on animals and these subjects, the dose for animal is different, for human being is quite different. So there can be certain other chances of hazards of the drug. So that's why they must go for investigation before marketing. So for such, a committee has to be constituted. So it has safety in what they check, safety and benefit of clinical investigation, overweight the risk in peer review. Then after that they approve clinical projects for the application of these investigational drugs. So what they do when before going to investigate, that committee have to send that. First, they get acceptance from the subject, the person, informed patient consent, whether he's willing to accept these drugs as an investigational drug or not. To be subject in research after having a complete information on the aim, protocol, and procedure of research. Then legal capacity to give consent. So they must inform the patient that you are a subject for this investigational drugs. If you say, yes, I am, then they have to apply the medicine on that subject. Free power of choice to withdraw. So if if they at any time that subject, the patient can withdraw, can go away from this project also. Hospital must have policies to protect human subject. So for this, they must have certain type of policies that they protect the life of that human subject also. They must get either written or verbal consent of that subject. Nature and purpose of study and its benefit informed to the patient. All inconvenience, risk, discomfort, hazards reasonably expected must be noted. Alternative treatment available with respect. So when they are applying their investing drugs to a person, they must have, if there can be hazards, side effects can be reported. So they must have alternative treatment to save the life of that subject, that human being, that person. General description of the study procedure and expected length of therapy may be informed to that subject or that person or patient. Investigation use only what they do. A statement that patient may withdraw, as I told you in previous condition, that he may is allowed whenever he knows he can withdraw from that project also. Investigators may remove patient from the study of circumstances warranted at the time he can report it. Any compensation or treatment that will be furnished in the event of if there can be a problem to the patient, there can, so some compensation can be given or treatment to the patient during that research project. The name of person to be contacted for answer if question about the study, a statement of whom will we have to access. So this is all has to be written in a pro forma before going to start a research study of a new drugs. If there is an exception, sometimes if there is a communication barrier, that patient is in a coma, so it's difficult to get consent from the patient. The patient cannot be approachable, so it is difficult to get consent. So what they do, consent must be in writing in phase one and phase two. Phase three obligation of investigator. It is responsible of investigator to obtain verbal consent, record that facts in medical record of the person receiving the drug. Physical and mental status should be considered while obtaining the data of that patient. Say another intimation to the drug authority. Now after that, after the investigation, what they do? They have intimation to the drug authorities. Evolution drug in human being have legal and ethical. So at this stage, what they do? They have to apply to that concerned hospital or wherever they are going to research. So first, they get the approval from that authority that we are going to investigation this research experimental drug. They must get the they have to first, but they have to submit a dossier in which the all detail of the drug has to be submitted. It go to a committee. It is in certain hospital experimental drug committee. Sometimes it is ethical committee, whatever. It has submitted that. Then what the duty of investigator? It has to notify drug authorities before initiating a search involving human being. Then the application has been submitted. Authority consists of scientists, physicians, pharmacologists, chemists, biometricians, microbiologists, surgeons, or whoever is the authority, the doctors who are concerned with that drug, or it is belongs to that specialty. If a drug of oncology, the oncologist may be incorporated in that that committee. Then what did this review ensure that the patient are not exposed to unwarranted risk? This has, so the new investigational drugs only for in vivo studies are exempted from pre notification or intimation to authorities, are labeled as cautions, contains a new drug for investigation use only in laboratory research animals, not for use in human. Or cautions, a new drug for test in vitro, not for use in human, but if research drug influence or change diagnosis and treatment, they notify authorities. If for antibiotics, new strain in chemistry and or resistance has to be done. The intimation of notification must have following information, complete composition of drug, its source and manufacturing data to show that appropriate standards exist to ensure its safety. Result of preclinical investigations, particularly on drug safety rather than its efficacy, data demonstrates no hazards on humans. Required information are pharmacological profile, acute toxicology and several species of animals, the route of administration used, very short-term studies from 2 weeks to 3 months to evaluate the toxicity. Now what they do, they a detailed outline of the planned investigation, information regarding training and experience of the investigator, an agreement from the sponsor to notify the drug authority and all investigators if any adverse effect arise during either animal or human test, the investigator's agreement to obtain consent of the persons on whom the drug is to be tested before the test is made, agreement to submit annual progress report and commitment regarding disposal of drug when studies are discontinued. So we'll stop over here.